inspiration comes, usually comes from something that I've seen. A picture of existing garment, a fabric often does, as well as sewing patterns. And then there's the stash. Stash is a collection of fabric that most sewists have, a cornucopia of fabric. noise there gets my creative juices flowing as a way to be able to create something. I picture the finished project in my head and then use my skills to make it happen. The outcome is usually close to what I imagined, and anything different is a designer's choice. I was invited to a Renaissance fair several years ago and made this dress. The challenge was in choosing the right pattern. The fabric, solid and a print. The decorative elements and accurate measurements so that the dress fit properly and to keep the cost down. I included a medieval pocket to hold my cell phone and keys. I fell in love with this upholstery fabric when I was at Hobby Lobby. And I bought 1 yard of it, not knowing what I would do with it, and came up with the idea of making a valance for my bedroom window and a matching pillow. For my bed. And I still love the fabric. A lot of what motivates me is something, to make something is the purpose of the project. It may serve as a creative outlet or to meet a need, such as a garment I can't find in the stores. Baby blankets, clothes, stuffed animals I've used as gifts. I feel that it gives me an extra something of myself, because I can. And then there's the camaraderie with other sewists. My mom taught me to sew as a child, as her mother taught her. During the time that I was living in Chicago, I was a member of the Haute Couture Club of Chicago, which sounds a little pretentious. And it was of the day. I called it Sewing Club. Easier to say. We had challenges each month for the whole group, optional to participate in, to create whatever the challenge was. A shirt. We were challenged to sew something with leather or leather shoes. And one challenge was to make hats. I follow a lot of blogs, sewing blogs. Get ideas from other people, and certainly tips and techniques. And I've attended many, many classes over the years to develop my skills. I tackle each project that I have as a problem to solve. What is the function? What is the need? What is the cost? The costs add up. For instance, this dress took approximately 15 yards of fabric. And at a conservative amount of $10 a yard, we're already at $150 for that shoot. It took me 10 to 12 hours to make the dress. And if I want to sell this to make money, that's another $200+. And then I needed to find someone who had sewing knowledge to help hem the dress because of some of the funky stuff that's going on down at the bottom. Costs are now at $350. So it's to take into consideration all the elements for the cost, because and being my father's daughter and very frugal, I paid about $50 for all the materials. I love sewing, but there are some things to take into consideration. Mistakes. I purchased some jean fabric and wanted to make the jeans right away, so I didn't wash it. So I made the jeans, could stand them up by themselves because of the chemicals that are put on them when they're manufactured, and proceeded to wash. wash it, and then the jeans shrank. It was 100% cotton, so I had to add an additional 2 inches to the bottom of my jeans. Yes, you could tell. Then there's the health hazards. I like to sew on bare feet. Not going there with the pins, although I know that's where you guys went. So my right foot works the pedal of the sewing machine, but my left foot is free to do whatever it wants to, and I tend to curl my toes under. After 20 or 30 minutes, this becomes rather painful, so now I wear a shoe or a slipper on my left foot to prevent this from happening. And then there